some of you may not know, some of you may. Living in Southwest Kansas, we have very, very small schools. I have a school of 145 people. My graduating class was 27. So we're a little slower with the advancements in technology and in education, and we just actually went one-to-one with iPads this year. And I only know this information because my dad is the principal of my high school, so he helped me out on this topic and knowing information on this topic. And it's a really big deal because we have very old Board of Education members, and they were not willing to get out of their comfort zones. But with the help of some of the younger teachers and my dad becoming the principal this last year, they finally decided to go one-to-one with iPads. And so today in my speech, I'll be talking about the technological advancements that can happen in our school, and also teacher advancements. Just because we advance the technology doesn't mean that our teachers don't need help on on how to, just lost my train of thought. Teachers also need help in knowing how to work the technology just like the students. So in our school, like I said before, we went one-to-one with iPads. That means that each student in our school gets an iPad issued from the school. On that iPad, there's no games, of course. They set it up to where you cannot download anything except Google Docs, which is what if we're using for the PowerPoints, and that's about it, an email. So with the chart on the screen, you can see that iPads is the largest group that schools are going to right now. And then the next largest would be desktop or laptops, which is what my school is actually going to next year. They're getting iPads and Chromebooks. I don't know if you know what those are. They're a Google product. And so, we're going to talk about the second main point, which is the teachers. So, the teachers are very old in small schools. They're not really bringing in new teachers to Southwest Kansas. So there are steps that need to be taken to provide the teachers with ample amounts of information on the new technology. So in my school, our teachers are required to go to two different seminars, one on iPads and one on Chromebooks. They actually had to go to Wichita for these seminars because we don't have seminars out where we live. So they're required to go. They can go any time of the year. They just have to come back with their own notes to show my father and tell him that they actually went. And secondly, the students can actually help the teachers just as much as the seminars can. I know that we all have phones and how to work those, and we can pick up an iPad even if we don't have one and figure out how to work it pretty easily. And so the students this year actually put on a type of seminar for the teachers and taught them how to play the games like Flappy Bird and Words with Friends. But they also taught them how to work Google Docs on the iPad and how to work email. And so the teachers aren't as afraid to use the new technology like the students aren't as afraid to learn the new information. So in conclusion, I'd like to wrap things up, and I hope I would like to talk about the importance of the advancing in schools. As the times evolve and as the technology evolves, it's important for schools to keep up with the new times to help the students in their education process. So I hope this information has informed you on how schools, teachers, and students are evolving as the times.